So I think this is going to be an interesting stream because I'm going to be doing a creature design. I wouldn't say creature, it's more like a dragon, but a feathered dragon. And I think it'll hopefully go fast because I like feather textures and I also like dragons and stuff. So, yay! I'm doing great. Thank you for asking. I feel a bit overwhelmed because the only reason I'm so late about streaming is because I've been looking at, like, a bunch of streaming stuff, trying to, like, figure out, kind of things that I need help with and, like, tricks and all that. Like, how to use this, like, software called Restream, which lets me, manage all of my chats all at once and lets me stream a whole bunch of websites at once. But not just that, but, like, also learning how to, like, what's the other one? What was it? Oh, yeah, setting up more accounts for other, like, art streaming places and stuff that I haven't really taken the time to do because I've only been streaming on Twitch. And then, what else? I'm trying to think. Setting up goals and whatnot. It was a lot, so I just felt kind of overwhelmed, but I'm happy. Sorry if you guys can hear the background. I think I'm just going to drink to celebrate the amount of work that I've gotten done, like, this last week, because it's been pretty crazy working on my comic and editing that. I'm gonna set up my drink and then I'll play music and get started.
these stars still shine for you. I'm looking up. I'm looking up for a way to bring you home. 'Cause I'm lost without you. Thank you. Stars still shine for you. I'm looking up beyond a crescent moon. I'm looking up. I'm looking up to bring you home, 'cause I'm lost without you. Your eyes, the first light, now we know that's wonderful. Your heartbeat, a wildfire. Stars still shine for you. I'm looking up. I'm looking up for a way to bring you home, 'cause I'm lost without you. Thank you.
transition is just so good. I want to hear it again. God, like, I'm turning it up. I'm sorry.
Seaside. till our lungs cave in, till all the worst lies, wait till they sink our swim, can make for the seaside. Run till our lungs cave in, till all the worst lies, wait till they sink our swim. For the seaside, until our lungs cave in, till all the worst lies, wait till they sink our swim. Make for the seaside, until our lungs cave in, till all the worst lies, wait till they sink our swim. Make for the seaside. Till our lungs cave in, till all the worst lies, wait till they sink our swim, can make for the seaside. Until our lungs cave in, till all the worst lies, wait till they sink our swim.
A dream that when I woke up you were finally there, that I believed that all the hours turned to minutes, it's not fair. And when I turned to look at where you should have been, I started drifting. Tried to stare into your eyes and realize that there was something missing. And if I stayed, I couldn't help but lie awake. 'Cause it's not you, it's just a dream, it's only fake. I just gotta leave, I gotta leave. Turn the key, I try to drive away into the night. I try to keep between the lines and out of sight. And when I look beside me where you should have been, I started drifting. Tried to stare into your eyes and realize that there was something missing. And if I stayed,
just a dream, it's only fake. I just gotta leave. I gotta leave.
far as it takes. And I'll go dancing till the rhythm is.
They're gonna hate me, but I'm repeating it.
Thank you.
seaside, until our lungs cave in, tell all the worst lies, wait till they sink or swim, can make for the seaside, until our lungs cave in, tell all the worst lies, wait till they sink or swim. Until our lungs cave in, tell all the worst lies, wait till they sink or swim, can make for the seaside. Until our lungs cave in, tell all the worst lies, wait till they sink or swim. For the seaside, until our lungs cave in, tell all the worst lies, wait till they sink or swim, make for the seaside, until our lungs cave in, tell all the worst.
I know I'm a terrible person, but I have to hear it again. So sorry. I have it like on repeat. Man, I love it so much. I love it so much.
Someone breathing. seaside. Run till our lungs cave in. Tell all the worst lies. Wait till they sink or swim. Can make for the seaside. Run till our lungs cave in. Tell all the worst lies. Wait till they sink or swim. For the seaside, into the lungs cave, tell all the worst lies. Wait till they sink or swim. Make for the seaside, into the lungs cave, tell all the worst lies. Wait till they sink or swim. Make for the seaside. Till our lungs cave in. Tell all the worst lies. Wait till they sink or swim. Can make for the seaside. Until our lungs cave in. Tell all the worst lies. Wait till they sink or swim.
A dream that when I woke up, you were finally there. That I believed that all the hours turned to minutes, it's not fair. And when I turned to look at where you should have been, I started drifting. Tried to stare into your eyes and realize that there was something missing. And if I stayed, I couldn't help but lie awake. Cause it's not you, it's just a dream, it's only fake. I just gotta leave. I gotta leave. Turn the key. I try to drive away into the night. Try to keep.
Yay! You can see my heart, but I'm doing it.
And when I look beside me where you should have been, a star.
Oh my god. I guess that it gets to pick.
That there was something missing.
just a dream, it's only fake. I just gotta leave. I gotta leave.
You guys are really funny.
Thank you. I'll take it slow.
is I picked out the design for the dragon, right? pick out some really awesome hummingbird colors that I think will look really, really neat on this dragon. I think hummingbirds are pretty underrated. I think that's the right word. Yeah, underrated. They're just so freaking colorful, and there's so many of them. They're really awesome looking. And I just thought maybe that would be like an interesting way to like combine two creatures together and make something kind of, I wouldn't say new, but something that's not done often.
Hey, yo, look at some bullets.
And yeah.
Shoddy and
one thing that makes me laugh is hummingbirds always look like they're so angry and pissed off. Now, as much as I really love designs like these because they're just so crisp. I wouldn't say crisp, but I don't know how to explain it. Like, this is just so vivid and bright, and it almost looks a little bit glossy or, like, shiny on the feathers. Whereas this design, oops, not my dragon, where is it? This one is, like, it looks very, I don't know if it's just the angle of the lighting or the type of feathers or whatever, but it's not nearly as, like, glossy looking or, like, crisp or whatever. But I like this color combo, and I think that it'll suit my dragon a little bit better than this will. I can try any number of like colors if I wanted to, but I think I'm gonna do this one. I think it's not gonna be so like outlandish, but we'll see.
I know.
Kind of starting with like the base colors, so this is in the shadows. Always, like, before you start your painting, decide what the lighting is going to be. If it's going to be in the dark, where is the lighting coming from, everything like that. I've decided that the lighting is going to come at least from behind it, or maybe possibly from this side, this direction. So I'm just gonna mark over here, like right here or here. I think I like up here more, so that it's only going to be his backside and these beautiful feathers right here that are going to be lit up. So I'll go ahead and erase the other one. And now that I've got that decided, I'm going to go in with like my lower lighting color and just kind of make everything a darker color. I haven't decided on the scenery around him, so I'm just kind of using my reference that I picked out. This is right here, my reference. I'm kind of going off the same rule that that has. Oh. So in the light, same thing. And the light is like the back of his head is like almost a true white, or it is a true white, where shadows and stuff are like more of a blue gray tone. So I'm just going through on my dragon and doing the same thing. I picked out like a purple blue gray tone, and I'm going through and coloring in like the parts that are like the darkest, anything that's gonna be like facing away from that lighting. And just coming up in here, doing that. I think this will be really beautiful. This needs to be kind of lit up because it's coming out not as bright as the rest of the body, but it definitely needs to be catching some light. The backs of the arms and the legs are going to be kind of lit up because that's where all the light is like seeping through and touching. So this is all going to be catching a lot of like light bouncing up into it. I'm going to darken, especially under like this area right here, because my dragon isn't very fat. I say fat, but like, he's not very, if he had a super wide stomach, like it came all the way out, then I wouldn't even worry about like making a undercolor right here, because it would be blocked off by everything that's like catching the light. But since he's actually very thin, like his body only goes to like right here, then that means we're going to be seeing a lot of like this underside, so I'm actually going to add some shadow right here. So we'll come in here, and then another thing to remember is his body is either, let's see, so like this is super important about like limbs and stuff, and you don't really see it enough. Man, I cannot talk today. You don't really see this enough, but like you need to think about the composition of your wings. So I'll just go ahead and mark, for example, the wings start right here, and usually with wings, this guy, can't really tell because of the shape of my reference that I'm using, but like usually when you have a creature that has like some kind of wing design, usually the wings come into the shoulder of the creature, so like whatever the shoulder blade is right here is usually, I wouldn't say connected to, but they should be equal with each other. That is a golden ratio rule with most creatures. You could do other things, but I don't think it's as realistic. So with that in mind, we come over to our creature and we see that the shoulder, like if I were to just like mark kind of where his arm is coming along, the shoulder would be roughly somewhere right about here. So that's where the tip of his wing needs to be like coming in. We'll go ahead and start coloring it. So if that's the tip of his wing, then that's going to be kind of lit up on this side, right at the very, very like tip top edge, because the light is behind him, right? So all of this is going to be touching it, but everything underneath it is going to be very dark. So this is all going to be kind of dark. And then we need to take into account how long his wings are, because most creatures, I mean, if he's actually going to be flying, then his wings need to kind of be big enough to be able to lift his whole entire body, unless you just want to say that magic solves everything. But realistically, his wings would be pretty large, right? So they're going to come all the way back here, which means that most of this is going to be pretty dark underneath. And especially up in here. This will all be really dark. Like directly away from the light. And I wouldn't do the shadows, the edges of his wings very dark right here, because his feathers are going to get very thin and fan out a lot. So we're going to keep these very light, but we'll worry about that later. So we'll come in here, and we've decided kind of where his underside of the wings are going to be, right? Now we're going to come in and just kind of highlight where we think the light is going to seep through a little bit, so underneath it. All this like area right here, right? So this part of his body is gonna be just a little bit lit up, kind of, not too much. We're still gonna see the shadows and everything, but it's gonna catch light right on his like stomach or whatever you wanna call that. And then another spot, you notice the leg right here is coming forward. You can't really tell because there's not a lot of detail. So this is all covered underneath. Because if we looked at this from the side, his body would be going like... How do I explain this? So like if we looked at his body from the side, like here's his head, right? This is a really terrible drawing, but... So this is his head, right? And then his like torso, and then his arms are right about here, right? And then when we get back to his body, where his legs are doing this. Right? So this part right here, this little area right here where his feet are, that's all gonna be covered by shadow, and this is all gonna be catching light. So we're just gonna copy that, but from this angle instead of from the side angle that I just drew. Basically right here is gonna be the most lit up because it's facing towards the light. And maybe all of this might be lit up.
Oh, hey, what's up?
And then, I'm sorry if you guys can hear the background, and then the underside right here is gonna be darker. And then the edges probably are gonna be catching a little bit of light. So like all of this is gonna be kind of something like this, not quite, but at least we've got it sketched out and kind of colored in. And then also under his face is gonna be really dark because there's a lot of spots right there that aren't touching the light at all and kind of being directly covered up by everything. And also on his tail, so like this underside of the tail is not gonna be catching any light. Also think about the shape of the tail, so like if you're ever unsure, it's good to go through and just take a marker. Sometimes I get confused too by the shapes of objects and stuff like that, so sometimes it's good to go through and just kind of trace over what you think the general shape is. So like some dragons have really fat round tails, so you would take like a bunch of rings and kind of copy them all the way up, but I don't think he has a very big fat round tail. In fact, it's more like a, I don't know what you'd call this, like a, almost like a soft diamond shape, so it'd be more like this kind of. And as the light, or not the light, but as the angle changes, so will the, like, tell. So some of these you won't even be able to tell. And then as it comes up towards his body, it'll start going in the opposite direction because it's coming towards us. So it'd be something like that, right? Kind of-ish. It doesn't have to be perfect because this is just concept art. And then as it turns towards you, you'll start to see it on this side, right? Because it's, like, coming towards the viewer. So this will kind of tell me where the light is going to be hitting, and this is important because, like I said, it's going to tell me where the light is hitting. So like everything up at the top is going to be incredibly lit up, especially on this side, right at his tail. So that'll be really lit up right here because that's flat, kind of. I wouldn't say flat, but the light is going to really be soaking into that surface. And then as we get further down here, it's only going to be the tip. And it's only going to be on this side, right? And then this part right here is going to be all dark because that's all facing away. And then way less right here, right? And then since the tail shape has that like little bump to it right there, like see that like weird like indent or whatever because it's coming out and then in, or in and out, whatever you want to say, there's also going to be a shadow there. So this will either have a shadow or a highlight, just depending on where it is in the picture. So we'll just come through with one last little thing and follow along that trail. And put one last little highlight on the outer edge of that. And if we get rid of our line work and we go back and look at it, now it should look really good. Or not, I wouldn't say really good, but now it should kind of feel like there's depth to it and it won't feel flat. You don't want your painting to feel flat. You want to try to avoid that if you can. But let me get rid of all this extra stuff and then we'll go back and look at it, kind of, sort of. This extra stuff, junk right here, all these little places that I didn't do well. Oh, I missed the other wing. Whoops! Okay, so we're gonna go into the other wing and just do basically the same thing. We're going to add a lot of shadow, especially like in this area right here, but not the edges right here where the feathers are going to be. This is all going to be, like, light is going to be coming through because the feathers are very thin. So the edges will be very light, but in here, like, this is very, like, basically the spot that's, like, the most away from the light, we're going to go through and make it all very, very dark. Again, if you're ever unsure, you can just take a bright color and kind of guess what the shape of the wings are. So wings are not like out right here. I mean, well, again, it depends on the animal, but you can very clearly tell that like my animal has this very like rounded out wing going in that direction, like the curve. So the curvature is going this way, right? And then it comes out a little bit because his wings are like bent, right? So we have this like bend right here. And this will come out and then back in again. So this will go in, right? And then it goes out that way. So that's kind of the general like structure of it. With that in mind, we can also kind of guess where the shadows are. So if the wing comes in and does that, then this is going to be lit up, and then this right here is all going to be really dark. So you can just kind of guess if you ever have trouble, and bring a really dark shadow in here and make this kind of lighter, and then bring up that shadow again. Keep the edges light, but we won't work on those just yet. I actually did it a little bit wrong. I didn't go in the lines. So we're gonna bring the color back a little bit right here. That's roughly where the wing should be.
Hey guys.
Cool whips. And make this kind of lit up. A shape, right? Or not a shape, but a dimensional feeling to it. It doesn't just look flat now. And then also we're gonna light up the tail. And now all of this is like lying flat on the ground. There's not any like any dimension. I wouldn't say dimension. I keep stumbling on my words. I'm sorry. Whose voice is that? Sorry about that. back.
Dear Mario, please come to the castle. I have baked a cake for you. Yours truly, Princess Toadstool. Peach.
Hello. I've lost myself. shadows holding on. All the things I resisted, now far from gone. How'd you get so far away from me? How'd you get so far?
God, it's quiet here. There's nobody in the background to like make noise. Holy crap. This is amazing. Let's try to do that. Yeah. I'm just slowly trying to fix its form a little bit. Little bit by little bit. I think I'm happy with its face. I think the wings need a little bit of work, but I'm just unsure. Because there's just. It's not really that there's a right, I mean obviously there's a right and a wrong way, but like I think it's more like it depends on at what point, like if you're watching a video, at what point you pause the frame and where you want the wings to be and stuff, so I'm like trying to like figure out and decide. Let's see if I could just take my own advice. I used a reference, but I didn't want to copy it completely, and I think at some point I should start, like, guessing, because I don't want to just totally, like, use a reference the entire time. I have to kind of learn for myself. Kiss, kiss, poison, at the poison, there, kiss, go. That's how I feel right now about writing the comic. I'm, like, trying to add as much, like, in between information as possible, so like I have to add more fluff, so I'm like Cusco's poison, poison for Cusco. Just like all the different ways that you could say the same thing, add fluff to the comic. It's like when Dory speaks well. I can't even do it, honestly. Well, I can't do it, seriously. Let's just give him a giant afro. One giant feather up at the top. Here comes. my body's coming together. Yes! Join our art Discord! It makes me happy when people post to their. Let's give him a cone head. Oh my god. Ha! There's so many things I can say about this. Actually, you know what? Like, I know we laughed about Blaze having a cone head, but like, on this dude, I probably wouldn't really mind that so much. Feel free to flood it all you want. I honestly don't mind. I say honestly, that's what it's there for. And the floodgates. The floodgates has been open. It's just put like a smiley face on his head. You call him Finhead. He must have hit his head really hard. Go for like one more hour. Pick this up tomorrow. I've been doing really good with my sleep schedule. I've been going to bed early. Animals so much. What is our obsession with them?
Childhood.
okay, you guys are gonna kill me, but like, I gotta hear this song again. Yes, he totally listens to SCR Daily.
Seaside, run until our lungs cave in, tell all the worst lies, wait till they sink our swim, can make for the seaside. Until our lungs cave in, tell all the worst lies, wait till they sink our swim. For the seaside, until our lungs cave in, tell all the worst lies, wait till they sink our swim, make for the seaside, until our lungs cave in, tell all the worst lies, wait till they sink our swim, make for the seaside. Until our lungs cave in, tell all the worst lies, wait till they sink our swim, can make for the seaside. Until our lungs cave in, tell all the worst lies, wait till they sink our swim.
That when I woke up, you were finally there. That I believed that all the hours turned to minutes, it's not fair. And when I turned to look at where you should have been, I started drifting. Tried to stare into your eyes and realize that there was something missing. And if I stayed, I couldn't help but lie awake. Cause it's not you, it's just a dream, it's only fake. I just gotta leave, I gotta leave. Turn the key, I try to drive away into the night. I try to keep between the lines and out of sight. And when I look beside me where you should have been, I started drifting. Tried to stare into your eyes and realize that there was something missing. And if I stayed,
just a dream, it's only fake. I just gotta leave. I gotta leave.
Take your last supply. better scene than what you found.
Steve.